Hello and welcome. I'm Han from 100 Drawers. In this tutorial video, I'll be showing you how to create this powerful dynamic filtering method to create a form that can filter data according to multiple criteria, all done by using formulas and no VBA code is involved. Let's say you have a large table of sales database, and you want to search through the database according to several criteria, such as order that shipped to Selangor, using courier service from Ninja Van, or search for orders since 1st of June to 30th of June, and order by customer Arthur within this period. As you can see, when I type in the criteria, the list below will get changed automatically. For expressive criteria such as names, phone number, addresses, and other string criteria, it is possible to search for partial characters. For example, if I input Art instead of the full name, order from Marta is also included, as the Art is part of Marta. This is useful, let's say you are looking for a tracking number. Simply input the last few digits to call up the order details. If you are excited to learn how to create this powerful dynamic filtering list, keep watching till the end. I'll be creating it from scratch, showing you how to create those formulas. If you would like to get along and create a copy as you go, head to the video description to download this template. You will need to have Office 365, Office 2021 or using Excel online for this template, as I am using the new formulas that are only available in these versions of Excel. No Google Sheets version available for now, but if somehow I made one in the future, you may also find it from the link in the video description. I am working to include an all order modules with this dynamic filtering to my previous template of 100 Drawers Shopee Calculator. It is a free template to help Shopee sellers to analyze and manage most of the data from their Shopee shops. Check out the link in the video description if you are a Shopee seller. The free template will help you a lot. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and leave a comment if you want to see more of these tutorial videos. Now, let's get started. Before we dive into the main content of this video, do note that all the order details are fabricated. You may see as I make a change to a cell, the details are regenerated. I am using RAND array formulas and based on these parameters for data generations. So, none of these order IDs, phone numbers, nor the tracking numbers is real. But for the purpose of this tutorial, I have made a fixed database on this data tab. The database is formatted as table, which I name it data. So I can address each column much easier, which will come in handy later in this video. In the main tab, there are pre-formatted cells such as the column width, merge cells, and some conditional formatting. These are just to help me coordinate through this tutorial much easier. If you have watched my video before, you know that I love to use a lot of helper columns. The section at the back is the helper columns section. It is used to calculate intermediate data that will eventually be used by the main list. Select all those columns and make it gray color to make it obvious. Section on the left is our main form. Select all those columns and shade it light green. So there will always be shaded cells, no matter how large or how long our data is. First 13 rows are the form for the users to interact with. So make it no fill. Next, we label the form. Invoice number, shop name, platform, order ID, shipping provider, tracking number, date, order status, completion date, username, customer name, phone number, and address. This top right corner is a filter for dates, from and to specific dates. The bottom right is the settings for sorting the list. We can sort based on these values. This drop-down list is just a simple data validation, like this. The cell below is for setting the ascending and descending order. Next, Let's hold Ctrl and select all the labels to format them. Make it green color. Border all around. Dashed line on the right. And solid line in the middle. Then Ctrl select all the entry cells and put on borders. The label for filter dates and sorting is in vertical mode. Solid line all around, but dash at the bottom. Fill with green color and click OK. As for the sorting fields, dash border in the middle and solid on the sides. For filter dates field, solid line all around and in the middle. Dash line in the center. Then we make these sub-labels light green. Oops, seems like I forgot to put in the title. I like to use a combination of emoji and text to make things more interesting. Before formatting the headers in row 15, let's make the borders for the list section. Select all the columns. Put on borders on the left and right. Then select the top section. Remove the border on the left right, but put on the border at the bottom. For the headers, select the cells. Put on borders all around and the center. Thicker borders at the top and bottom. Fill with green color. Label all headers. Invoice number, date, shop name,
platform, order ID, username, customer name, shipping provider, tracking number, order status,
and order income. We have done formatting the main section. Now, let's go to the helper columns. I have pre-merged some cells here. These are the headers for the intermediate calculations. Select all and put on borders. Select the merged cells and put darker green fill. The row below, we can use a normal green to differentiate the structure. This indicates there are two categories of helper columns. First is match, and the other is filter. There are two more generic values we need over the top. Set up the borders for them and put on various green colors. The first one is data size, and the next is sorting ID. As for the headers in the merge category, we have from date to date,
status, completed date, shop name, platform, username.
In the filtered category, there is invoice number, purchase date, and completed date. And that's all for the formatting we need. There are some conditional formatting I did not show to save time on this tutorial. It is just to format the list at the bottom. You will see later in this video. Now let's start working on the formulas, where the real magic begins. These helper columns essentially validate the inputs in the forms with the database for every order. I make use of the spill range functions or array functions to help me validate all the criterias. Which means if you have 500 orders like in my demo here, there will be an array of 500 validations for each column to check if which order meets the criteria. For this from date, we need to check if the input field is occupied. If it is empty, we need it to return 1 for every order, or else return empty. Remember that I said I use format as table for the database? We can call up a whole column of invoice number like this and check if it is empty. If it is not, return 1 or else return empty. This is a trick to generate an array of 1 validation that has the exact array of data as the order count in the database. When I press enter, it will return 500 ones. So if the user did not input the date in the form, all orders are valid. But what if the user does input the date? For that, we can call up the purchase date column. See if their date values are larger or equal to the input. If it is true, return 1, or else return empty. That completes this helper column. We can test it by inputting 1st of July. and only orders with purchase date later than 1st of July have the one validation. The next column, to date, is similar to from date, so we can just copy over the formula, change the conditions to less than or equal to, and move down the reference cells. Try 15th of May, and now the orders with purchase date before 15th of May have the one validation. Next is order status. It is an expressive criteria. Expressive criteria contains text rather than numbered values, so the formulas will be slightly different. First, we check if the input field is occupied. If it is empty, we use the method before to return a one validation for every order. And then when the users input something, we use search to look for any partially match between the input field and the database. Then we enclose this one with an if error function to return empty if there is no match. The database I prepared for this demo does not have any order status other than completed, so I am not able to demo the expressive criteria for the order status. But I believe you have already seen the demo on other expressive criteria earlier in this video. Coming is the completed date. For this, I designed it to look for a specific date rather than a range of dates. The same thing again. We first check if the input is occupied, return one if it is empty. Then we check on the matching completed dates for every order with the criteria. If I input 3rd of May in the form, only orders with a completed date of May 3rd are valid. The rest of the helper columns are all expressive criteria. We can reuse the formula from the order status and just change the cell reference and database column for every one of them. Now, the helper columns in match category is finished. Moving on to the filtered category. The first column of this category is the invoice number for all the valid orders from the match category. So we use the filter function, get the invoice number column from the database, filter based on the criteria that this array is not empty, multiply the next array is not empty, and so on, down to the last array. At the end, return empty if it is not found. Next, since we have all the invoice number that matched all the criteria, we can get the purchase date and the completed date for each order. The reason to have these three columns in the filtered category of helper columns is that we want to allow the user to sort the list based on these three factors. Remember the drop-down list at the sorting settings? We can get the dates by simply using the XLOOKUP function. We want it to look for the values for the invoice number array in the invoice number column of the database, then return the values in the purchase date column in the database. Return empty if not found. The same formula goes to the completed date column. The data size here is actually the data count of the filtered result. We use count A to count the data. And then minus 1 if the result is empty, or else if there's no matching result, the count A will still return 1. For the sorting ID, we want to let the user select which criteria to sort by. To do that, first we check if the input field is occupied. Then we use the XMatch to look for the column count from here. Return 1 if the input field is empty. Sorting ID of 1 means the list of order will be sorted based on the invoice number. 2 is the purchase date, and 3 is the completed date. You will see how in a minute. As for sorting in ascending or descending order, it will be addressed later. That is all for the helper columns. Now, we can get back to the main list. The invoice number column. First, we check if the filtered result count is greater than 0. If not, return empty. The sorting process based on the three columns is all done here. We use the sort function to sort the three helper columns in the filter category. But these are three separate arrays. We can't use the hashtag spill range to reference them. Instead, let's use the offset function. Offset from this cell, 0 row and 0 column away. Height refers to the data size and 3 columns width. Back to the sort function. The sort index just refers to the sorting ID we prepared earlier. As the sorting order, we first check the sorting settings. If it is descending, return a negative 1, or else return 1. Close the if and sort functions, hit enter, and you can see we have all 3 columns listed out. Now, here's the conditional formatting I mentioned earlier. It shades the even rows and gives borders to rows that are not empty. Back to the result. These 3 columns are not what we actually want to show. Instead, we just need the first column of invoice number to be showing. To do this, we can wrap it inside an index function. Skip the row number argument and put 1 in the column number argument. Hit enter and it will only list out the invoice number. Nice. Things are getting easier from now on. Since we have the results for the filtered and sorted invoice number, we can simply use the XLOOKUP function to look for all other details. XLOOKUP. Look for the invoice number from the invoice number column of the database and return the purchase date. Return empty if not found. For an extra steps of error proof, we can add an if to check if the invoice number array is not empty, which is really optional. Now, we can copy the formula over to all other columns. Just change the return column in the XLOOKUP formula. And that completes the entire spreadsheet. Let's test it. We want to search for orders that are sent to Sarawak from 1st of June to 30th of June. Ta-da! Or we want to see all orders by the customer Arthur and shipped using J&T Express. Besides that, we can also sort the list below based on purchase date, change the sorting order, or sort it by completed date. As this is finished, we can hide the helper columns to make it tidier. We have come to the end of this tutorial video. Hit the like button if you like this video. Leave a comment and let me know if you would like to see more of these tutorial videos on this channel. Head to the video description to find links to download this template, both finished and empty template. Subscribe to my channel. I would love to share more of my knowledge on spreadsheet making. And I also provide free templates for various use cases. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!